This is Napoleon Square in the town of La Roche-sur-Yon, the capital of the Vendée region.
This area is known worldwide for its excellent orange-flavored battery brioche. I have been invited to meet Lionel Guilbeault, chef of the Petit Ventre restaurant, to taste his specialties cooked in earthenware pots. My dish of Mojette, a local bean, slow-cooked with confit garlic and lamb shoulder, is really satisfying. I also enjoyed my dessert called briochin, made with brioche and caramel-flavored cream cheese. On his 4-acre farm, Aurélien Chenet grows cereals to feed his pigs and much-loved free-range chickens, called poulet blanc fermier. It pleases me to know that his chickens enjoy plenty of space and natural food.
This braised chicken and cabbage is a rustic dish of this region.
I first drop 4 cabbage pieces in boiling water and leave for 5 minutes. I then transfer it to cold water and drain it. I heat a little oil in an oven-proof pan and brown some bacon for a few minutes. I add some butter to the pan to delicately brown the chicken on both sides. Next, I add 50 ml of dry white wine, 8 juniper berries, some thyme and a bay leaf, as well as some carrot pieces, some potatoes, the cabbage, and season with salt and pepper. Then I pour in 50 ml of strong chicken stock.
This lovely winter dish is also often prepared with guinea fowl or pheasant.
I cover tightly with foil to keep the heat in and also with a lid, and cook on low heat for half an hour. After which, I turn the bird over and cook for an extra 20 minutes. I portion the chicken and serve it with the vegetables, a little broth and a sprinkling of chopped parsley. This poulet braisé au chou vert is a true classic farmhouse dish of the Vendée region. My next gourmet adventure is at the patisserie and chocolatier Patrick Gelenzer, where some of the most delicious and artistic cakes and ice cream desserts in the region are made. They also make their own chocolate from cocoa beans. Guillaume Tremblay, the chocolate maker, takes me through the complex process.
Bon, on commence par sélectionner des fèves de cacao de plusieurs origines.
The chocolate maker then slowly roasts the fermented cocoa beans before crushing them to extract the nibs. Next, the crushed nibs are ground with sugar several times to obtain a smoother texture.
Le but de toutes ces étapes-là, c'est vraiment de développer les arômes.
The last step is a slow mixing of the smooth chocolate. It's called conching and refines the flavor and texture of the chocolate. It is then ready to be used. Here, the chocolatiers are making a bonbon with a chocolate from Peru with 75% cocoa butter. It won a gold medal at the 2017 International Chocolate Awards in London. I must taste it.
C'est délicieux. Tomorrow, I am in my beautiful native region of Anjou to taste some great food and beautiful wines.